After a devastatingly long pause, 3 months without comics, 3 months, but DC Comics got a Diamond distributor back the other day saying they're going to go with a different distributor going forward. But anyway, as comics slowly begin to return, today was a banner day for DC Comics as they finally introduced a new female character that they've been planning to introduce for some time. It was supposed to debut like a month or so ago. But this is particularly important because flashy female characters are big in comics, and particularly for DC. It's one of the only areas where they consistently are full of win. So Punchline, yeah, kind of a big deal. Is she the Joker's new girlfriend, partner, victim? The details are still sketchy. We'll have to see what happens. Stay tuned, right? Same bat time, same bat channel. But let's go over what we do know now that two very important comics, as I said, have hit the marketplace. And also, I want to talk about how Punchline reflects a surprising amount of comic book history. Is she that well-researched? Is this that smart? I would love that to be the case. All right, so anyway, while these comics, again, were delayed by coronavirus, today DC Comics released both Batman 92, featuring Punchline's first official appearance, and then, it wasn't supposed to be on the same day, but they came out on the same day after all, Joker's 80th anniversary, 100-page super spectacular, which sounds like a supervillain event, right? And that features Punchline's way too short, sloppily short, we'll talk about it, origin story. But she's out there. I have to say, off the bat, how old is Punchline? Because in Batman 92, she looks like Harley and Catwoman's peer, but then in her origin story, she looks like Joker's intern. Kind of an important point. But again, before we discuss what we think of Punchline, I want to go over the details. All right, so her real name is Alexis. No last name just yet, which is interesting because there has been some speculation in the fan community that she might be an Asian character. That still hasn't been clarified, unfortunately. And also, speaking of unfortunately, it's very hard to tell in the comics sometimes what ethnicity a character is because it's like the dirty secret of comics. All faces look the same, they just change the hair. Most artists can only draw one face. It's just, as I said, people don't really talk about it, but it's a harsh reality of comics. So I would like them to clarify that, and it would be a great opportunity to have a new character of color. That would be, also there's not a lot of Asian representation. You know, it's usually martial arts fighters, so to have someone outside of that, I think would be really cool. Now, like Harley, we first meet her at a college. This time, it's Snyder College, which is not Zack Snyder. I believe it's named after comic book writer Scott Snyder. Big name in DC Comics. Has wrote the Batman title himself for a very long time. Currently working on a lot of other very big deal projects. And it's interesting to me because Punchline co-creator James Tynion IV is kind of Snyder's Punchline. Tynion was one of Scott Snyder's students at Sarah Lawrence College, and then Snyder was the one who got him in the door at DC as a writer. Now, to be honest with you, I have never liked Tynion's work. Usually when he jumps on a comic, I jump off the comic. I'm just being fair here. But right now I have to say he's on fire with his Batman comic for three reasons. Number one, he's following Tom King's hated run. And Tom King's run was good at first, but then it just dove off a cliff. It's all Tom King's fault. He got fired off the book, pulled off earlier than he was supposed to leave it. So here comes Tynion. Two, maybe in an effort to make up for what happened with King, but DC Comics editorial has given Tynion Batman's full rogues gallery to play with, and it is glorious. It reminds me of the work that Jeff Loeb and Tim Sale did with Long Halloween and Dark Victory. It's really great. And then three, he's got Guillem March and Jorge Jimenez as his artists, and great art helps every comic. Another, someone who's written comics, it's just a reality that everyone has to accept. Art sells the comic. Writing gets people to stick around. It's a visual medium. Also, I want to point out that Guillem March is a very detailed artist, so it's hard for him to be consistent as a penciler. That's why he's usually a cover artist. But he's done Gotham City Sirens, he's done Catwoman, the very, very, risque and controversial run that was recently there when she and Batman were hooking up all over the place, but really tremendous artists. But it's Jimenez who is the co-creator with Tynion on Punchline, and this could be quite the feather in their cap if they pull it off. However, cramming her origin story into a couple of pages instead of a genuine story arc across multiple issues or a graphic novel like Harley Quinn where her origin story was done. She, of course, just first appeared in Batman the Animated Series, much like Punchline was supposed to just first appear. But I think to, you know, fill in the background story on her, I would have appreciated a little bit of a deeper dive. But I do like the way she uses her name. Punchline! She's where the joke ends. That's very clever. And borrowing a bit from 2019's Joker, she's not just an anarchist, but she's an activist, tired of playing by society's rules because she thinks those rules are a joke. That's excellent. A Joker groupie, she proves herself by mixing her own Joker toxin, which she finds the recipe for online. It's revealed the Joker is hiding in her closet, which I think is a bit beneath Joker to hide in a dorm room closet, but whatever. And also, that's interesting, talking about sometimes, you know, the Joker's sexuality is called into question. I don't know if this comic is that. I'd be surprised if it was that deep. I would love it, but I don't think it is. But anyway, she cleverly hides the Joker toxin in a cigarette, and then she blows that, which allows her to blow Joker smoke in someone's face. I thought that was a very nice touch. I thought that was very cool. And she kills the dean of her college when he comes to talk to her about her choice of hero. I won't tell you the full circumstances in case you'd like to read the comic yourself. And sure enough, she captures the whole thing on her phone, which she then posts on Instagram. I added that part, but I think that's clearly implied. So I'm like, wow, that's really, you know, it's weird to have such a modern version of Punchline, and then you stick her next to Joker, who they've modernized in the films. I think even though Joker took place in the 80s, it still, I thought, was a very modern version of the character. But in the comics, he's still very 1940s stylized. So to have him in a zoot suit and his spats next to someone who's Instagramming stuff, it seems a little weird to me. Anyway, she'll be featured, it seems, heavily in the upcoming Joker War. I don't know if she'll make it out of Joker War alive, but she's going to be featured heavily in that big crossover event. I'll be reading it because it's called Joker War. And then so I'll see all this other stuff happen. Her costume is much sexier than Harley's. Even the Suicide Squad one. As you can see, it hardly can contain her. She has a marionette doll-like look with the makeup, which I like her design quite a bit. And then she has X's and O's on her gloves and her boots. Hugs and kisses, tic-tac-toe, or video game console symbols? I think that would be great. I wish she had all four of the symbols, but I don't know if they want to make her that modern. And while Harley likes a weapon she can swing, Punchline is all about sharp edges, from her earrings to her knives to her personality. On that note, she's also all business. Very big change of pace from Harley Quinn, obviously. She wants to get right to the bottom line, to the punchline, right? And she's quite the monologuer in her origin story. I don't know if that's because it was sloppily written and they didn't have time to do proper exposition. So she just, you know, it was very much tell, don't show, which is a cardinal sin for a visual medium. But they did it. But anyway, if she does monologue a whole lot, I can't see the Joker liking to share the spotlight. And she calls herself his partner. I mean, she's clearly delusional, but I don't think Joker's going to like someone going around saying that either. Now, comics history-wise, I see two comparisons here. The first, a friend pointed this out to me, and I think it's very clever, is that this creates a Betty and Veronica-type duo for the Joker. Does that make Joker Archie? That's kind of weird. He does dress in the 1940s style, right? I'm like, who's Jake? I mean, the metaphor only, I think, ends at Betty and Veronica. But I like that. I like that. Adversaries over the same guy, but also friends? Frenemies? I would love to see. You know, Harley, I think this is one thing Margot Robbie got right. Harley Quinn's very much about her female friendships and the way she interacts with other characters. That's, of course, supposed to be with Poison Ivy, not Birds of Prey, but I digress. But it would be great to give her a friend, you know, because her friendship with Poison Ivy, of course, has become a romantic situation. So it would be great to see her just have a friendship kind of situation or a frenemy situation with this Punchline character. We'll see if they reflect Betty and Veronica's famous personality traits, and I think so far they do. They kind of do, which I think is fascinating. Now, I have mixed feelings about Joker taking on another sidekick, right? Harley was supposed to be a special situation. Now, this maybe points out that she wasn't at all a special situation, which I can see as being an important development because Harley, of course, is, you know, taken off the rose-colored glasses in terms of her relationship with Joker. So this would be even more of an eye-opener, I think. I did like what she first says to Punchline about how someday they'll be friends and talk about all this. And then they fight. But anyway, what does Joker want with the sidekick, though? It was Harley's idea. to be his sidekick in the first place. I mean, is Joker just trying to make Harley jealous? Is this still all about Harley? I don't know how I feel about that either. I think, you know, it's very important to maintain Joker's personal dignity. I don't know if I want to always shift the focus to female characters instead of him. He's supposed to be the main event. Although I think we have come used to seeing him with Harley. I don't think that means we want to always see him with just a belle de jour, right? I mean, the comics also have pushed the idea that Joker's real obsession is Batman. So does he want a Robin? And does that mean after Punchline, the Punchline's delivered, will he go find another sidekick, right? Now, speaking of Robin, what I also think is fascinating is that it seems like Punchline is Jason Todd to Harley's Dick Grayson. And of course, we all know what happened to Jason Todd. Who kind of like aggressively sought out Batman in the same way. Although Harley sought out, it's interesting. But I do like the Jason Todd comparison. I think Punchline is very much like Jason Todd. And it would be an impressive thing to see her storyline reference Jason Todd, who of course again was killed by Joker. I don't know if Tinian's up to it, but I again would be super impressed if he is. And that would mean a gruesome fate though for Punchline, although maybe then resurrection, because Jason Todd of course was just too delicious to leave dead. So I think the character has tremendous potential. Tremendous potential. I think she could be at the level of the other fantastic, great female DC characters. The only other comic book property that has as good female characters is the X-Men. So I'm excited about Punchline, although I will say I'm a bit disappointed in her debut. Let's see how this develops. So what do you think of Punchline out of the gate, the very first Punchline? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.